Let me know which is your favourite off the bunch. Would you download and use these lovely babies? I will, of course. That's still such a strange sentence. Hey folks, this is Best in Slot and welcome to Jurassic Park Baby Edition. This is thanks to a brand new baby dinosaur mod by Mitchell Productions, adding a humongous number of brand new baby dinosaurs to the game. We've dabbled with a few of their baby dinosaur mods in the past, but this is 2 to 3 times bigger than any of those past packs. And of course, there's quite a lot to showcase. I'm going to show you every single baby dinosaur variant in this video, so we wouldn't really fit it all into a standard mod spotlight, and it's so cool. It really deserves its own individual spotlight. And to be honest, I wasn't going to upload today anyway, so consider this a bonus video. So let's check out some babies. That's a strange sentence. Right, so I've set up all the individual pens and we're using Cryodenic's lovely little fences because that kind of sells the baby vibe a little bit better. So we've actually got gates over there, so we're gonna go check each individual pen. But you can see over here we've got some baby ankylosaurs, and on the left hand side we've got some baby Allosauruses. Unfortunately, there they are. Hello. We're gonna hop inside the pens and get a slightly better look here. I just think you could make some really fantastic, you know, family units, petting zoos. It really opens up the world to some fantastic variety. So there's our parent Allosauruses of any denomination. Hello. And there's our little Allosaurus. And as you can see, they're not just they're not just scaled down versions. So if we pause it here for a second, you can see it has been remodeled. It's got a large head, it's got big eyes more than anything else. And it isn't running on like a scaled down Allosaurus rig. It is running on a small dinosaur rig, something, I mean, it seems like the compy, something more appropriate for a dinosaur of its size. So you get all these adorable little baby Allosauruses, and we can finally have proper family units, proper Site B looking parks, all this kind of jazz. And there's so many of these, as you're about to see, that, you know, you've got all the variety in the world, and I really hope they continue to expand this. You know, even maybe the most popular mods have baby versions of those. That would be awesome as well. Okay, you're very cute. You know what I should have done? I should use invisible fence. Anyways, kind of builds a little bit of drama. We love drama. So there's our Ankylosaurus family. And there's the little baby. The problem with some of the babies, of course, is they're babies. They're quite small. And that makes them very hard to see within the grass. But yeah, so again, you can see the same kind of deal there. This adorable little thing. That big head, those big eyes. That tends to be the main change. You know, the big eyes more than anything else. The big eyes alone sells baby. And you can think, I think if you look across the two, you can see some differences in the body shape, how hunched it is, stuff like that. This is lower to the ground, feels like it's not quite grown into that big old Ankylosaurus shape quite yet. The head spikes are a little bit less developed, stuff like that. And it's got this adorable little mouth, which again is a strange sentence. Hello, little guy. So yeah, very cute. There's our baby Ankies. I think this is Velociraptors. So we've actually got two Velociraptors in there. We've got the standard Jurassic World Velociraptor, but we also actually have Blue as well. Blue has a baby version. We'll check that out in a second. But first we have our Triceratops. This little one is eyeing me up. It is, again, you can see more differences with the trike. That front nasal horn has been shrunk down a lot. The actual horn, the two higher horns are a little bit smaller as well. The crest is much less developed. The head is teeny tiny. You know, it's got more, you can see, I mean, look at the difference. It's pronounced. There's a real remodeling job going on here. It isn't just a shrinking down and, you know, obviously the rig differently and stuff like that. And they've got those big old eyes. They're very, oh, hello. And because they're on, you're about to see it now, I think. There you go. Just had a little bite of the tail. Because they're rigged onto smaller dinosaur rigs, they will work social animations and all that kind of jazz. The mod page, hello. The mod page does mention that there are some problems with the release animations. So if you're going to play with these, it is suggested that you manually place them into your game using, say, Cryodenic's Wii Toolbox, which is how I did it. And here we have our Velociraptors. Is that a little blue? No, that's a standard raptor. Tell you what, these are going to be quite hard to see because they are teeny tiny. So I think what we'll do is we'll hop into... There's a little blue right there. We'll hop into capture mode and see what we can see. There you go. There's little blue there. So this is, I mean, this is Blue from the film. You know, she was in baby form in Jurassic World at some points, and there she is. The raptors, it kind of feels like more they've just been scrunkled together. I think those are official terms. You know, it's just kind of squished together a little bit. But obviously there's some remodeling again. I feel like the back vertebrae is always less pronounced with the babies more than anything else. And they've got sort of chunkier heads and smaller necks and stuff like that. But obviously we've got Blue there. She's having a little sit. Oh, God. I'm very zoomed in. Blue's having a little nap. And of course we have our regular raptors. That's actually the weird skin that we don't look at. Like this one over here. This lovely white skin down here. Next to Blue. There they are, little baby raptors. You can have tons of these in a much smaller habitat. I kind of made all the exhibits the same size for ease of use, but I think if you shrunk down the exhibits in particular, you could have something. That's something really cool. You gotta keep a move on. We've only done 4 species. Like a quarter of the way through. So over here we have something, and over here over there we've got Stegosaurus. Not sure what's in this one at the moment. These guys are, look at that, it's half the size of a blade of grass. It's nearly impossible to see. When this one wakes up, hopefully we'll get a better look at it. They're all here, they're just hiding amongst the grass. These might be the smallest babies of the lot. But again, I think the frill and the crest have been shrunk down. Can you wake up, please? Have been shrunk down a little bit. You're also sleeping your eyes open, which is very creepy. I don't approve. Okay, so get on the beach. There it is. bounding along on that Compsognathus rig. And, yeah, very cute. Teeny tiny. The real true juvenile Dilophosaurus finally discovered. So they'll never, like, full-on pull their frill out, as you would expect, but, they're gonna do some very cute compy animations instead. Alright, let's go check out those stegos. The herbivores are so much nicer. They're so much bigger and easier to see. God bless the herbivores. So we've got our stegos here. Beyond the rock, very Lost World coded. There it is, there's our Lost World stego. And there are lebebas. Again, same kind of deal. So the body feels, I keep wanting to say scrunkled, like it's an actual word, but scrunkled. The tail feels a little bit shorter. Maybe the neck's a little bit thinner on these ones compared to the parent. And then the major difference, obviously, is in the head shape. You know, it's a little bit less defined, less shaping going on there. More of just a ball of head. And then the eyes are absolutely gigantic. And it's sweet. It's cute. And it kind of feels very much like a baby Stegosaurus probably would feel like as well. I'm not going to pretend that all of these are like hyper paleo accurate or something. I think that would be expecting a bit much. But they add, like I said before, I think they just make your exhibit so varied and just, you know, look at this little family unit. I think that's super cool. I really want to build like a petting zoo or like a proper natural. Maybe we could build, what's that park we did in Jurassic World Evolution 1? The bio park, the naturalistic park. That, but focused entirely on like mixed unit, like family unit kind of builds. Might be really interesting. Anyway, with that first 6 done, we're going to head over this side and check out some of the ones over here. I think this is Carnotaurus by the looks of things. Let's have a little poke. There's our baby Carno. Very cute again, same kind of deal. Everything shrunk down a little bit and then obviously those gigantic eyes. And Mama's here to look after them. It just looks great. I can't get over it. It's fantastic. I know some people, aww, get a little sad because, you know, maybe you're playing on console, you're not able to mod the game and stuff like that, which is totally understandable. I absolutely get it. And, you know, obviously baby dinosaurs is something people have been requesting for a long time now, and I think maybe if we ever got, again, I don't think we'll get Evolution 3, but if we got something like it, maybe Bubba dinosaurs would be included in that. But hey, you've always got Prehistoric Kingdom, which will have baby dinosaurs pretty soon, so keep that in mind. Anyways, our baby, adorable baby Carnotaurus is there. Sprunkly, as they say. Anyways, here we have Parasaurolophus with fairly humongous babies, to say the least. These are large, chunky babies. The really cool thing about this, I should have mentioned, is obviously that, as you can see here, they're using the skins that the parents do. So, like, the patterns have all been transferred over. So you could have the parents having certain skins and having the babies only having those skins, or even meshing the two together. You forget sometimes how gigantic Parasaurolophus is. It really is so much larger than most of the dinosaurs in the game. It is humongous. And very noble. Looking after its bebbers. I don't like the skin at first. It's really growing on me. But everything looks better in capture mode. And like, look at them just hanging out under the tree together, you know, nesting and stuff like that. That's fantastic. I'd really recommend this mod as well. You can't see it here. You may have seen it a little bit over there. There's an egg on the ground. There's a mod called Life of Dinosaurs, which adds sort of eggs and nests and stuff like that to the game. Really cool nesting materials. Really good for this kind of exhibit. There might be a little bit of it. That there's part of it. I don't know what that is, but it's part of it. Right, one more for this section. And over here we have Baryonyx, I believe. There you are, little Barry. Again, same deal. Big old eyes. Big eyes. Scrunkly little body. I'm just leaning into that now. Scrunkly's a word. I think when I say scrunkly, everyone kind of knows what I mean, even if it's not a word. Maybe it is a word. Yeah, there's our Baryonyx. There's the parents, and you can see the difference between the two there. Again, I feel like the head is always less well-defined. You know, all the little bumps and crannies haven't quite come in yet. You see the bumps on the back are maybe less well-defined as well. And then it's got those gigantic eyes. Absolutely humongous. A little terrifying, the Baryonyx, I would suggest. But that's okay. Who isn't? Oh, it's kind of cute. No, it's a little terrifying. Who isn't a little terrifying now and again? Now, you might be sitting there thinking to yourself. Actually, I'm sure you are all sitting there thinking to yourself. By God, best in slot. That sure was a lot of babies. Too many babies, some might say. It's something I think. Oh, something I really think. Oh, it just looks great. I can't get over it. It makes me so happy. Something I think all the time. Anyways, too many babies. This isn't even it. There are six more, ladies and gentlemen. Six more. So follow me down into the woods to the final six species. There's really no good reason for that to be part of the video, but I feel like it added to the drama. Right, so as I say, we have six more. There are, if you include blue, 16, but if you just look at individual dinosaurs, there are 15 different types of baby dinosaur added to the game. And of course, these don't replace anything. This is all variants, so you can release them all from the same hatchery. Although, like I said, you shouldn't with the babies. So in this one, we've got, as you can see, Pachycephalosaurus. Very, very similar to the parent in this one, I would suggest, the Pachycephalosaurus. Just those big old eyeballs being a little bit spooky. Yeah, a little preview. I'm very excited about the Dreadnought, as you can see there in the distance. I'd love to see more sauropods as well. Yeah, there's your little gang. Yeah, very similar to the parents. Again, I feel like the spine has been brought down a little bit, like the hump there is less prominent in babies. The head's simplified again. The shape of the skull's been brought in a little bit in general. The snout is definitely shorter as well on the baby version. And then gigantic eyeballs, of course. I think this is the Dryosaurus rig based on... Wait, no, that noise isn't Dryosaurus. That's Homolocephaly, isn't it? Is that Homolocephaly, that noise? I should know, I've murdered about 5,000 of the bloody things. Right, let's go check out the other side over there, which looks to be... Giganotosaurus. So, this isn't a mod thing. My Giga was being really weird today. It kept crashing my game every single time. If you're my Steam friend, you'll have seen me load Evolution 2 about 50 times this evening. My Giga just was broken. So, I couldn't spawn the parents in. So, this is just a ragtag group of juveniles living their life. And as you can see, the Giga is actually the film version, which is pretty cool as well. Again, gigantic eyeballs. I'm going to keep saying that every single time. They look kind of like the little baby Godzillas from the 1998 Godzilla. And you know what? Seeing them like this, it reminds you just how fantastic. I mean, some of the best pattern work Frontier's ever done on this Giga right here. I think it's absolutely phenomenal. So look at this. That is a beautiful dinosaur right there. It really is. All right, let's check out the Spinosaurus whilst we're here. Little baby Spinosaurus, because we've seen the Spinosaurus before, I believe, in previous versions of this mod. It's cute. So the hump seems to be like it's higher up. You can feel there's always like these little changes. It's less developed down here, but it's higher up there. Big eyes, of course, as I keep saying. Snout a little bit shorter as well. Different rig, different sound effects, all that kind of jazz. It would be funny if it made the full-on Spinosaurus roar, despite being a tenth for the size. But no, they've got these lovely, oh, the lovely little cute noises. Very appropriate for the dinosaur. and looks fantastic, as it always did. Again, it kind of, you know, the Spinosaurus in the film, for example, is all blood, lust, and murder, and eat everything that moves. So seeing it rendered here, you know, like as a family unit, it's quite nice, actually. You can really give your dinosaurs a whole different feeling by just giving them some kids to look after, essentially. It's kind of like a cheesy film that Arnold Schwarzenegger would have made in the 90s, where he's like an assassin, but then he has to raise a baby. You know, it's kind of the same deal with the Spino. So here we've got the Dreadnoughtus. I'm going to check out the babies over here. You can see the main differences there. Very skinny in the neck. Eyes. Oh my god, that's terrible. Jesus Christ. Are you less scary? Nope, they're all terrifying. Absolutely monstrous looking up close. Yeah, the Dreadnoughtus is an interesting one. The eyes are horrifying. But you see the main difference here is it's skinnier, but obviously it's, you know, smaller, but it's also skinnier. Like the body isn't as thick, and the neck in particular feels quite a lot smaller, quite a lot thinner. I also think it might be shorter relative to the body length compared to the parents. They were a little terrifying up close. They were a little terrifying from a distance as well. But it's still very cool to see. Right, folks, only two left to go, but two I'm very excited about. I'm going to save that one for last because I'm actually most excited about that. So over here on the right, we have ourselves Tyrannosaurus Rex, of course. Which, again, is another one we've seen before, so I think quality-wise is really, really good. The head feels like maybe a little bit too adult, but again, the snout has been brought in. It's got a much rounder head. It's got those big eyes. And obviously the cool thing about this is that we can, you know, the Lost World Jurassic Park it up, essentially. We can have the baby Rex and the two parents. I don't think there is a direct skin like that for the babies. Like, I don't think you can have the movie skins on the babies unless I completely missed it. But you could make a green Rex and, you know, it'll be close enough. They're very cute. Again, baby Godzilla 1998 vibes going on here. It looks like the you know, the parents are hanging out and the kids are doing kid things, exploring the area, play fighting, maybe trying their own little hunt for the very first time. I just think if you want to tell a story, if you want to do like a site B, if you want to tell a story with your exhibits and you want to build something naturalistic, this is a must-have, near enough. Anyways, this one is, of course, brand new and very exciting. This is Gigantoraptor, so you will need the appropriate DLC for this one, the Cretaceous Predators pack. And you will get yourself some adorable little baby Gigantoraptors. I'll find one that's a little bit less in the grass so we can get a good... there's a bunch of... Oh, there we go. See, again, got a social animation going on, which is really cool. Clawing at each other. Those feathers still render, I mean, they're a little bit wild, to say the least. They're very shiny as well, for some reason. But they look like beautiful little birds, you know? They've kind of lost that Gigantoraptor. You can see this as just lovely little birds that you'd fill your exhibits with in general. You don't even have to be a Gigantoraptor. You just use them as kind of like, you know, when you go to a zoo and there's always a peacock wandering around. I don't know why that's a thing, but there's always a peacock wandering around the zoo. You could use this as the kind of the equivalent. Until Mama shows up and eats your face, basically. Anyways, yeah, Gigantoraptor. So, as you can see, 6 there. And 9 there, including a double with the raptors and Blue. An incredible, incredible, incredible pack. Took me nearly half an hour to go and look at them all. There's just so much here. 15 new species of baby dinosaur to make your beautiful Site B naturalistic style parks. Really want to do something with this. I'm not sure what it's going to be quite yet, but it's definitely in mind. Yeah, cool, isn't it? Let me know which is your favorite of the bunch. Would you download and use these lovely babies? I will, of course, still such a strange sentence. I will, of course, link these down below in the description. Go give Mitchell Productions lots of love for this as well, because it's very, very well deserved for releasing such an awesome pack. And yeah, so like I said, I wasn't planning to upload today, so I've got to go do other things with my life. But for, you know what, couldn't deprive you of me for an entire day, so what can I say? Thank you so much for joining me. Throw me a like down below if you enjoyed the video, and I will see you lovely folks very, very soon. Cheers much of as always. Bye-bye.
Bye.